Lauren Williams from the United States.
And Lauren has always been a big time performer. She was a silver medalist back in 2004 when no one really knew who she was. And I asked Lauren, I said, Lauren, what are you thinking about on the starting line? And she told me, honestly, I'm just trying not to faint. I'm almost sick to my stomach, but she said she knows when she's nervous, she's ready, because every time she's entered a competition and she did not have those butterflies in her stomach, never run well. She knows what she needs to do here today, get out of those blocks.
And her mom, Donna, watching. There's some tension right now, but it is amazing how Lauren seems to always rise to the occasion. Karan Stewart of Jamaica has looked good.
Yes, she has. I think she's looked better than everybody else in this entire field. And she said, you know, she grew up watching Merlene Adi, and she wanted to accomplish half the stuff that Merlene Adi has. Well, if she is able to win Olympic gold, she will have done something that no other Jamaican female ever has, and that is to win that 100-meter gold medal. And of course, the entire Jamaican contingent back at the village watching Usain Bolt set that amazing world record of 9.69 last night for 100 meters. And that has to do wonders for the confidence of this Jamaican contingent of sprinters here in this final.
Muna Lee, the U.S. champion.
And Muna Lee has had a big year this year. She called her old college coach, Pat Henry, and asked him if she could move to College Station and train under him. He made a deal with her. He said, if you would become the volunteer coach here at Texas A&M, you could come here. Well, she hooked up with Vince Anderson, and she said the chemistry has been absolutely fantastic for her. He has brought back her confidence, and she really feels like she deserves to be here now. Exactly how she was in the final at the 200 meters in 2004, she's back.
Lane one is open. In lane two, Sharon Simpson of Jamaica, hurt most of last year, but returning to the form that saw her ranked number one in the world in 2006.
And if she can run one of those 2006 type races, she becomes very dangerous from the outside. They won't be able to see her. Good starter.
Lane three, Debbie Ferguson McKenzie, one of the golden girls from the Bahamas in her fourth Olympics.
And she's so powerful. If she gets out well, like she's capable of, she can be right there in the mix towards the latter stages of this race.
In lane four, Shelly Ann Fraser of Jamaica won her semifinal race in 11 flat.
Along with Karan Stewart, she looked very good through the first three rounds. Like Usain Bolt, no experience at this level, 21 years old. That means she has no baggage to bring to this race. She could very well end up winning the whole thing.
Muna Lee, well, she was precocious as a youngster, but not in track. She learned to play the piano by ear at three and continued her music through high school, playing other instruments, now hoping to add an Olympic medal.
So dangerous towards the latter stages of the race. She won the U.S. Olympic trials by passing people in the last third of the race.
In lane six, Tori Edwards of the United States.
I remember when she was one of the youngest members of the team. Now here she is, a veteran, and this is probably her last shot at Olympic gold. She did not look particularly good in the semifinals, but in Osaka she looked great in the semifinals and had an awful final. So it's possible that here she is in her last chance. She can summon the form that saw her run 10.78, the fastest time in the world this year.
Lane seven, the Jamaican champion, Karan Stewart.
Has to be considered the favorite, the former Lady Tiger from Auburn, but she has not had good luck when it comes to 100 meter finals. But she's shaking her head yes, reminiscent of Bolt last night, very relaxed, and that's usually a good sign. The favorite here in this 100 meter final for women.
Lane eight, Lauren Williams.
There is not a better big meat performer in this field. She's been there before, edged out in 2004, and you better believe she starts well when it's crunch time. She will put herself in a position to win and put pressure on the Jamaicans as well as to her countrywomen to her inside.
That was her mom, Donna, cheering. And in lane nine is Jeanette Barkey of Great Britain.
And she surprises with a fantastic start in the semifinal. If she gets a start like that in this final, she could be a spoiler here tonight in Beijing. Williams knows that all she has to do is start well, and she gives herself a very good chance.
It's a fair start. Simpson down on the inside, Lauren Williams, and here comes Fraser. And Fraser of Jamaica running away from the field to win it in 10-7-8.
And I said the youngsters have no baggage to bring, reminiscent of Usain Bolt, 10.78. The one athlete in there, the youngest athlete with no experience, blows away a very, very good field. And now, Jamaica 48 hours ago had never had a 100-meter champion, either male or female. Now they have both.
Shelley Ann Fraser of Jamaica.
And it appears, Tom, that Jamaica has gone 1, 2, and 3. We're trying to sort out the minor places. But Shelley Ann Fraser, what can you say about the 21-year-old? The only experience she has at this level is that she ran on the second place 4x1 last year in Osaka. And midway through this race, it was never even close. She got a great start and just kept going.
They're still examining the photo to determine the other placings, but Shelley Ann Fraser left no doubt as she blew away the field in the final meters to win in convincing style.
And Jamaica is in fact 1, 2, 3. We just have to sort out who in fact will get those silver and bronze medals.
While the Jamaicans celebrate an apparent sweep, Lauren Williams with disappointment looking up at the big scoreboard, apparently finishing in fourth place. Let's watch the finish now in slow motion and see if we can see the second and third placings as Simpson and Stewart hit the line together. Lauren Williams appears to be fourth. Here's the official photo, and it is a dead heat. A dead heat for the silver medal, Sharon Simpson and Caron Stewart of Jamaica.
And Tom, what a race for this young lady. Watch Tori Edwards in lane 6 flinch right there, but the starter does not call it. Shades of John Capel in 2000 Sydney in the 200. It did not matter. Shelley Ann Fraser, second from the right, got the best start in the field along with Sharon Simpson on the inside lane. And from there, it was never in doubt. The youngest, the shortest, the least experienced member of this field blows away the field by 0.2 of a second to win in 10.78.
And a big smile as she crosses the finish line in a margin of victory similar to Usain Bolt last night. Jamaica looking so great at these Olympic Games in the sprints. They record the first ever sweep in the women's 100 by any country. And the new champions with Bob Neumeier.
Well, Jamaica continues to roll. Shelley Ann, your thoughts on winning this gold medal?
Well, honestly, most people weren't expecting me to come out here and do something. So with that in mind, I know it wasn't do or die because nobody expected anything. So I didn't have to go out there and prove to anybody, just to myself. And I went out there and execute properly as my coach told me to, because I was having a bit of problem with the reaction times. So I worked on that and then I just come out here and do my best.
Did Bolt's big performance last night inspire you or your Jamaican teammates in this one?
Yes, and the fact that Asafa is my training partner, I also came out here to represent him.
For Jamaica now to win this two nights in a row with two 21-year-olds.
It's just crazy, amazing. I mean, all love to Jamaica. I mean, the support has been tremendously. And I don't like to say, I'm so excited, honestly, because, you know, it's for my first major title. And it was good. I worked really hard for it, though.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I think she's going to be smiling for a long time. Jamaica's first ever women's 100-meter gold medal and the first ever sweep by any country as Simpson and Stewart dead heat for the silver. Lauren Williams fourth, Muna Lee fifth, and Tori Edwards eighth and last. It was ladies' night in the 100, a wide-open race with six of the eight runners from either Jamaica or the United States. But Shelley Ann Fraser, like Bolt, 21 years old, had a lightning performance, winning resoundingly and leading a Jamaican sweep, shutting out the Americans. A disappointment at track and field for the U.S. and a signal that Jamaica will be a major sprint force for years to come.
This program has been produced by NBC Universal in association with the International Olympic Committee and the Beijing